Hello and welcome back to our RedRun challenge in Monster Hunter Generations, where we've just reached high rank. Hi. So let's see what high rank quests there are available from the start. So I know we've got to do this one, and not this one. This one. And this one. And this one. There's a handful of ones that we have to do. Unfortunately, none of them give us anything we super want. At least, none are guaranteed to. Like, none... None feature Garuga, is what I'm trying to say. Garuga, or Laggy, or Glavinus, etc. And we're just doing this one with the two birds. Because... Oh, these are good foods. Though they would be better if I didn't have health plus 50. Yeah, we're doing these ones, these birds, because I think they might be able to give us the keen bones we want, or whatever the hell kind of bones. I know we need bones. So I'm going for things that might conceivably have bones. I feel like it's a good strategy. Ooh, we're probably going to want more pickaxes. And we can probably buy megapicks now. We sure can. Alright. Let's store the flash bombs. We're not going to use those against these birds. Yeah, we ought to be good like this. Okay. Oh, we need to care about stamina restoratives now. That's right. So this quest might get a little painful depending on when we manage to have the supplies delivered. Hey, look, it's a King Scarab. If this was my Freedom Unite run, I would have been really super happy about that. But in this run... I don't know to be happy about it yet. Maybe it's good. Oh, we don't have paint either. Ooh. We are very unprepared for this quest. But that's okay. When have we been super prepared for any quest that was the first in its rank? Also, wow, that was a really fast charging of files. Chipsaros really does not deserve this music. And did you catch how tasty that Tailspin hitbox was just there? Tail went right over our head, and so did the hitbox. It was great. Okay, you can spit poison on my back. That's fine. I'm good, cat. Okay, I see an option here. I'm gonna try and take it. Provided the bird lets me. Oh, that's right. Weapon was sheathed. Very nice being able to block that. Shame that wasn't a mount hit. Okay, that'll get rid of the praise, which, if this was Freedom Unite, I would be super ultra pleased about. But since it's Generations, it's just a thing that's okay. Nah. There's our ride. And then we can focus on trying to get a KO. Maybe break the flashy thing. That would be nice. I don't care that you're struggling again. Now, will we get... Nope. We will not get screwed over by the wing. That was accidental. A product of the fact that I was holding down on the control stick rather than back relative to the camera. Bit of a waste of files and red shield, but we'll manage. We won't die for it. Okay, I guess I'll be in here then. Getting my red shield back. And some health as well. Health is good. I was about to try and increase my stamina, but then I remembered it's been like this since the start of the quest, and I don't have any curatives. Well, restoratives. There's nothing to cure. Oh, thanks, Katku. I totally needed that fireball. Let's just get these two spitting on each other. So, where are you going, Gypsaros? That-a-way, huh? As much fun as Kutku is, Gypsaros actually has some stun built up on him. And it shouldn't be all gone yet. So I'm gonna see if I can't finish the KO. Because that's what I would like to do. Just finish the KO and then go ham on the flashy thing with my axe. Or he can draw his face out of harm's way. And then run over my cat the moment it tries to do any healing whatsoever. And again. But he saved us from the waste of the vat. And from the use of the grammar. Ow. There we go. And there goes the flash. Ow. I really wish I could do something about my stamina. Yo, buddy, I'm gonna need you to do something that puts you out of commission for a while. That works. Not as well as I'd hoped, but hey, it worked! And we didn't get poisoned. So I guess it worked exactly as well as I had hoped. Okay. Trying to, well, Gypsaros can be poisoned. It's not Garuga. So yeah, this is just fine. We just need it to actually get over here. Or it can leave immediately. I mean, that's also an option. Wanted to make sure we knew that poisoning is its shtick, I suppose. Okay, good. I did guess right about which direction it was going. Oh, hey, it's other bird. T- Oh, got a twofer. It's so cute that you think you still have a flasher. And we've got the healing chorus over here. And there goes the Kutku. If it heads towards the trap, I may follow it just so that I can make sure to get some use out of it. But it's not going towards the trap, so who cares? Not me. And I need to find a time to use this energy blade. So if you could try and flash, that would be amazing for me. Thanks, buddy. I was kind of hoping he'd do the run forward and peck a bunch of times attack. Because if they do that on the red shield, then they just apply a bunch of stun damage to their faces. Which always is silly and fun. Breaker is, of course, going to end before we can make use of any additional files, but still gonna charge them up so that I have some spares for the next time I use all of mine. Now, is this thing really dead? No, it is not. Okay, I was gonna try and kick it to death, but then my cat threw a boomerang through it and proved that it had more than one HP. So I think it's best if we just treat it like a monster that's still alive. Because that's exactly what it is. You could just die already, that would be great. Or do something incredibly stupid like trying to flash me with no flasher. Okay, and it's dead for reals this time. So we get to grab our carves, and then we have to go find the Kutku. That's gonna be a bit of an issue. No dragon seer, no paint, no psycho serum. Farcasters don't help you find monsters. Ooh, two blue nodes. Or no, that's one blue node and one node that just kind of looked a little blue from that range. I'll take some carbolite, please. Ooh, I need more stamina. But supplies just arrived, so we can make our way to those. Yay, carbolite! Yeah, let's head back to base camp to grab the rations that just showed up. Mining along the way. Okay, Dragonite's fine, but it's not Carbolite. Any more mining nodes in here? I feel like there should be more. Oh well. We can also grab some paint from the base camp, so Kutku will never get away from us once we find it. And there is a fairly limited number of areas it can go to. And they're, for the most part, connected pretty well, so shouldn't be a huge issue. Also, there's always the chance that our cat decides to be useful and reveal it on the map. It does have Monster Dar, after all. There we go. Nothing like a maxed out stamina meter. So, now to find us a big pink bird. Shouldn't be too hard, right? Just gotta search around. I know it can be in the nest, I'm just not going over there just yet. Because it could also be in either of the two areas that are connected from here. Okay, it's here. Thanks, cat, for showing us it was in the area as we were loading into it and would have seen anyway. No, Kutku, you don't come closer here. We want you to stay on one side of the tunnel rather than going into it. Good job, cat. Unfortunately, no sparkly from that one, but they can't all give sparklies. Yo, bird, get back over here. Where are you even going? Where are my cats even going? Wow. I don't think I've seen Kutku do that in this game before. No, Kutku, get back over here. Now this I've seen Kutku do plenty of times. But Kutku, you've gone a bit too far. You see, I want you to hang out right under this ledge. That's what I want. Now I'm sorry to say, buddy, but your fireballs, they're not you. Yeah, they're not. There you go, that's what I wanted to see. Hey, buddy, you want to get back over here? That's a good bird. And there's our ride, which, if everything goes according to plan, will come with either a face break or a stun. I would honestly accept either one. Or both. Will the wing get in the way? It will not. And we got our face break and our stun. Now, the wing getting hit here is not it getting in the way, because the wing actually takes the most cut damage out of any part of the Kutku. And we just happen to be at a perfect number of remaining files for a Limit Breaker Recharge Energy Blade in that order. So there's our Limit Breaker. What are you doing up there, buddy? Other than spitting fireballs through walls. So now we need an opportunity to use Energy Blade. This'll do. Yep, someone did not enjoy that. Ow. Oh. Thanks, Cat. And away goes the bird. Shame we never got to use the poison pit. Would have been nice. And I'll go ahead and just shove what files we have now into the axe. / shield. Oh, tired bird. So let's see if we can't build up another energy blade before running out of Limit Breaker. Oh, you jerk. Of course, my using files is kind of running counter to the goal of get an energy blade ready before Limit Breaker goes away, but we've got the meter for it. We've got the files for it. Now I just need the sharpness for it. I mean, technically we don't, but of course, having higher sharpness is having higher damage. Which is a goal worth pursuing, I feel. And we got it on the wing, which is great. Because again, the wing takes the most cut damage. Ow. Thanks, Cat. I'm a little surprised I didn't get hit there. Haha. Oh, and someone's almost dead. And fell over. Let's just go ahead and do the full thing and then miss horribly. That was a bad decision. But hey, what would this run be if not a series of bad decisions? Okay, he's actually stopping in here. Or just not at all, he's going straight to the nest. Why doesn't Rathian do that, huh? Thanks, guys. Cats, stop. I'm doing this for my energy. Not because I want them dead specifically. All right. So, now I'm going to sharpen. And then we're going to get in there and I'm not going to embarrass myself with my poor aiming. Probably not going to get a kill either, but still, it'll be satisfying. Yep. About as good a wake up as I could have managed. Cutku still had quite a bit of health left. Which makes sense, it is a high rank one. There we go. And there are new mining spots, which is good because we might get more carbolite. And I want carbolite. I don't know what for, but I'm sure I'm going to need a lot of it. Okay. Bit of a time waster there. Also, no carbolite makes me sad. I don't need macolite. Didn't get nearly as much carbolite as I wanted. But oh well. And hey, we did get some keen bones. That's great. I think if we'd gotten one more, I might have had all I needed. But now we know we can, in fact, get keen bones from Kutkus and Gypsyrosses. And that's good to know. Wow. Wasn't even aware that he was that big. And someone wants to talk to us in Berna. I'm guessing it's Hunter Arts Man. Nope. Oh, it's Palico Ranch. Saying, hey, your Palico's done Palico'd. Yep. They sure did done Palico'd. Well, let's head over to the prep area and get us a weapon upgrade. Now, we did have that little discussion about how upgrading this is probably going to result in higher damage output against things that don't resist fire. But I'm still going to upgrade this one first. Oh, takes 3 keen bones, so we do need 2 more. And I'm upgrading this one first simply because I like blue sharp. It's nice to not bounce off of things. So let's do 2 of these and 1 of these. And bam, we done upgraded a thing. And wow, we already have almost all we need to upgrade it again. Just a Wrath Medulla, and that should be pretty easy to obtain once we hit HR5. Wrath Medullas are fairly common. And HR5 is when Wraths start to show up in high rank. So, yeah, we have a pretty easy path to upgrading this thing. That's surprising and very welcome. But this is where this episode ends. Join us next time for more high rank questing. See you then, friends.